Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to Peek Over My Shoulder as I mosey about in Lifeless Planet. We have reached some sort of suspected culmination point here. And I have actually played a little bit of this, but I fucked some things up, so I closed the game and restarted. Now I can't remember exactly why.
Portal creators recalibrated the portal away from Earth and back to the alien homeworld. And the Russians were afraid of what might be on the other side.
Right, we will have a recording here.
Из-за колебаний энергетической мощности, которую мы впервые наблюдали прошлой зимой, мы были не в состоянии пользоваться порталом. После несчастного случая мы решили подождать несколько недель и посмотреть, не стабилизируется ли портал. Этого не произошло. Более того, прошло уже много месяцев с тех пор, как мы могли отправить кого-нибудь через него. И вот вчера, когда я проверял это устройство, я стал свидетелем чего-то, что меня в одинаковой степени взволновало и ужаснуло. Сквозь мерцающий свет портала, на какое-то короткое мгновение, я увидел фантастический инопланетный мир с невероятными архитектурными сооружениями. Похоже, что строители портала перенастроили его на новую цель. Их родную планету. Теперь нам лучше не стоит и пытаться путешествовать сквозь него.
You didn't think this thing all the way through, now did you? Okay, I am going behind the corner now, and I am going to obtain myself a handy jetpack booster. Maybe not from here. So, during my first attempt after this checkpoint, I managed to repeatedly get stuck in some textures here. Okay, I am going to have to go on top of this wall. I also jumped up to these pipes. They're empty. I also fell into the pipes, but I got out. It was just 5 minutes ago, but now I don't seem to remember why I wanted to return to the checkpoint. What was... lived your life in Soviet Union and you expect things to just go well? Please. This is not like this expedition is not like from the 50s. It's from the 70s, late 70s. People had way more realistic understanding of how shit works then. Even the Kool-Aid guys. I mean, especially the Kool-Aid guys. Okay, so this was the point that I decided to reload. But why? What did I do? was checking for possible mineral samples. And then I died, maybe? Science. Yeah, that's the yellow one. Oh, now I know. It wasn't anything to do with the game, it was that I had forgotten to unfold the mic. That was it. That happens. Okay, so I take it we have to make it to the other side here. Yoink! Hello. Yeah, this area would play a lot better during nighttime. I mean, like real nighttime. Right now, I spent my night play session doing the daylight and twilight sequences. There will be a lot of digging around in this area because I suspect some mineral samples are hiding somewhere here. For example, what's that over there? If this area is anything like the Monument Valley, then it should be technically possible to go down to the ground. I think, maybe, perhaps. Let's try this now so that I know at least. Oh, okay, so I can't get down from this point, apparently. Okay, we need to go that way. Okay, so we can... Oh! Oh! Forbidden, I suppose. I mean, one could just walk down from here, just saying. And in the Monument Valley, there totally were samples down in the ground. Oh, come on. This is just silly. Oh well. Okay, so that way. Yoink. Just look at all those plateaus and little craters and crevices and shit. Zone. Stay off the sand. But tease. Okay, so footprints go down there. But I want to explore up here for a moment. Can we go around? Yes, we can. Ow. Whee! Oh. Maybe not that way. Cushioning. So the eventual path leads there, but what about the immediate area? lie, I'm not a huge fan of third person perspective to begin with. Excuse me, options, do we get, give me options. Oh, we have an option to leave this off. But we don't, we can't do anything with the sound, so ignore it, I guess. So yeah, I am no fan of third person perspective to begin with. And in nighttime environments like this, it's extra annoying because I can't really control the light. Actually, let's try this. What happens if I take this off? Doesn't seem to change much. Either I have learned to move better, or this is actually a little bit better for controls. Or not. Okay. Give me my mirrors, bitch! Where am I now? I got myself disoriented. Okay, that's the bright light over there. That's the path over there. I was making a 360, I guess. That's the red alert patch, which probe the edges of the canyon. For good measure and such. Stay on the stony surfaces, but also keep eyes open for artifacts. Oh, we have to do that. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Good old quartz. So I guess the samples are numbered by the type. I don't know. I just don't know. Like, above everything else, I don't know if the bonus doodads numbers reset every play session, or if different items are counted separately, or what. So it might be that that I need to find a certain number of certain doodads, or it might be that they are just all mashed together. I don't know. It gives me unease that I don't know. Now I can't really see where I can and where I cannot go. Oh shit. Let's get on these rocks so that I can at least take a good look around. Okay, looks like I need to go over there. And the searchlight seems to confirm that, I think. There's some sort of ledge over here. Funk! Let's look behind the corner. Not quite what I meant, but okay. us. Okay, I think we need to go here now. Save point! What could possibly go wrong? Well, there is some doodad over there. Don't you shine that thing in my face, come on now. I'm at the mercy of my little flashlight as it is. How am I supposed to find artifacts this way? Like, come on. Be nice. Uh oh! Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! That happens. Now I have lost my orientation. So, not that way, I take it. No, no, maybe not that way. I need to go down from here or what? No, wait. Okay. At this point I can't tell which way I came from. Yeah, I think I'm headed the right direction. Just hop on the rocks. Oh, and the real life daylight just got more intense. Oh joy. Used to be such a perfect day for indoor activities, like heavy rain and all that. Can I see any doodads? I see sand dunes which might pose traps. I am repeating some of my steps now because I am not sure which places I have checked and which I have not. And I will not leave a doodad behind. What now? That way are the industrial ruins, and this way is the mushroom thingy, and this way is where we're going. Got it. Well, that was a nice soft landing. Wasn't so hard, was it? To have a memory of dreaming of this sequence, especially the frustration of flashlight. Stay on the rocky ground, also maybe just bounce away from these fellers, but also check behind each rock because that's where the minerals hide themselves. I think I reached a dead end here. Yeah, because we're now closer to that formation. And as beautiful as that is, I don't think we actually have to go to it. In fact, going to it seems to be highly impractical. Trying to continue on. I was already over there, so where did I go from? Can't see shit. Really, game. Get your shit together. thought that the camera off center would help with this, but apparently not very much. And now there's literal sun shining in from my window. Not helping! Okay. I don't know if this is the way or if I'm just strong-arming my way through now. Okay, I think this was the way before I started meandering. Okay, some sort of jump-off ledge leading to... am I going back? Or are some of these elements just similar? I mean, seeing one ledge, seeing them all, am I right? Progressing, I think. I'm almost certain that there is a hidden doodad here. If for no other reason, then this is exactly the kind of spot where I would inconspicuously drop one myself. Then walk away, whistling innocently. Visibility is becoming a serious problem. Please excuse me for a second. Improvement, but somewhat. So, do we actually see anything ahead? Okay, it seems... No, wait, we came that way, didn't we? Okay, I think we didn't, because the searchlight is that way now. Yeah, I haven't done this jump. Look at you go! And to think that a mere 20 hours ago you didn't know how jetpacks worked. Poof! Are like the pet or the house plant of the portal builders. How's it hanging? Okay, let's look around for notice. Basically circling around or like circling at the top rim of this crater. There's a dude out there. Maybe research.
Говорит доктор наук Владимир Керимов из Советского космического агентства. Я записываю это сообщение в надежде, что когда-нибудь эта запись будет услышана, и наша миссия на этой планете будет понята. Это была мирная миссия. Мы обнаружили в Сибири портал 22 года назад, в 1974 году. Это загадочное устройство могло мгновенно перемещать людей и машины с Земли сквозь пространство прямо на поверхность этой планеты. Планета имела очень богатую биосферу, необычную и в то же время прекрасную, а также атмосферу, благоприятную для жизни. Было решено, что Союз должен застолбить для себя этот мир. Поэтому самое удивительное открытие в истории человечества держалось в тайне. Наши лидеры хотели построить новое, идеальное советское общество. И так, в довольно короткое время, мы основали колонию, насчитывающую сотни людей. Вначале эта планета была очень многообещающей. Но спустя несколько месяцев команда наших ученых обнаружила, что местная растительная жизнь стала вымирать. Мы невольно завезли вирус, который убивал похожую на мох субстанцию, покрывавшую поверхность планеты. Эти организмы были основным источником питания местных растений. И когда они вымерли, вместе с ними вымерла и жизнь на всей планете. То есть вымерло большинство жизненных форм. Некоторые организмы остались, и они подверглись ужасным мутациям. Они жадны до любой пищи. Мы потеряли почти всю нашу колонию по милости этих существ. Даже в данный момент, когда я делаю эту запись, они подступаются к нам. Мы отошли к самой высокой точке Восточного ущелья. Мы надеялись добраться до древних электростанций. Но это слишком опасно. Я не знаю, как долго мы сможем продержаться.
Well. Theoretically, there could be like a few lone survivors, or well, lone and or a few survivors from the original expedition, but it's unlikely unless they have adapted, become something else. Okay, seems like we need to jump, which means I am going to examine this field once more, because again, this is exactly the kind of spot where one would encounter an artifact. to have one though. Aww. Poof. Do we get to, do we need to go to the top of that one as well? Doesn't seem so, but can we? Check it out. Oh, well then. She's been all over the place. Okay. Even though I drew the blinds on, the daylight is still kind of strong. Dunes again. Let's see if I can get to the topmost doodad. Don't mind me, just browsing. Okay, now let's take a look. Seems empty. Whee! Ah, we're closing in on the footpath now. I mean, tracks, footprints, tracks. Oh. Oh well. No more jumping for us, I guess. For artifacts and minerals. Mineral artifacts. Okay, so that's where her path picks up again. Is that a doodad? Yeah, that seems to be something to interact with.
This structure doesn't appear man-made. Was this what the Russians were trying to reach?
It's a good idea to rest until morning, because then we will have daylight and shit. But at the moment we have some minerals to find, don't we? Mr. I don't know. something turned on there. Ah, it's reflecting the light of the searchlight. How far up can I go here? Can I, like, get over here? I think I can get over here, but what about... Okay, rock face. Hello. Do we get daylight now? Pretty please. Yes, and we get a save point. Holy shit. It has been an adventurous and frustrating night crawl, and I think I will call this episode here, even though it was shortish. But I want to start with fresh head. So thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.